So what on earth am I doing when I'm playing that minor turnaround? Well, I'm playing 2-5-1 in the key of D minor, okay? So the two chord is E minor 7 flat 5. That's E, G, B flat, D. And the five chord is A7 with a flatted ninth. A, C sharp, E, G, B flat. Now, of course, we can stop at the seventh, but the ninth is such a characteristic part of this minor scale that you might want to include it in your thinking, in your walking line, something like, right? You definitely don't want to play a B natural. That'll sound really wrong in this key. All right, and the one chord is D minor with a major seventh. So it's D, F, A, C sharp, D. If I go, take it up the octave, D, F, A, C sharp. Okay, I think it'll help to clear this harmony up a little bit if we go to the keyboard. So I'll be now making my YouTube debut on keyboard. Now you have to promise not to laugh at my keyboard technique. 2-5-1 in D major is this. E minor 7, A7, D major 7th. Okay, so all of the notes from those chords come from the D major scale. All right? Now, when we go to the key of D minor, we have to make sure that our 2-5-1 chords come out of the correct scale. And the scale we're talking about today is D harmonic minor. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just like you have on almost all of our major minor scales. 2, 3, 4, 5, then the minor 6th, and then the raised or major 7th. And remember, the reason that we raise that major 7th from the natural minor is so that we can have this. 5 going to 1. Because without that C sharp, it sounds pretty wimpy. Right? That's not very much help in jazz anyway. Alright, so here's the two chord in D minor. Alright, so I've got 1, 3, flatted 5th, 7. Now I'm going to lower the top note, just like we did before, and play the 5 chord. And now I'm going to keep the B flat because it's such a nice note and it really does give us the flavor of minor. And when I keep that note, it gives us this nice colorful flatted ninth. Okay? And then when we resolve, the final chord is minor with a major seventh. And the reason that we have the major seventh is because, remember, it comes right out of the scale. So we can't use the minor seventh like we would on a normal two chord, let's say, or a six chord. It's got to be, if we're going to be consistent with using the notes from the scale. All right, one more time. E minor 7 flat 5, A7 flat 9, D minor major 7. There's your 2-5-1 in D minor. So now that I've thoroughly confused you with how the chords move on the piano, what does this mean for us as bass players? Well, all of the same rules of voice leading, when we go from one chord to the next, apply regardless of the fact that this is now in minor. So let's just talk about some good approach tones, and I'll have you think about how you want to integrate these into your playing, okay? So if we're going from the E minor 7, play the E in tune, we have almost a whole two octaves of that arpeggio, because we're fortunately starting on our lowest note. We can approach the new root, which is A, the 5 chord, by going from the G, which is the third on the E minor, right, up to the new root. And of course that works in both octaves. G, A. Okay, so we're talking about beat four now on the E minor 7. 4, 1. That's the beat, beat one of the A7 chord. How about another one? Well, how about let's use that nice flat 5 with, so that we have some a half step passing note. The B flat going down to the A. So here's the flat at 5th. Going down. Okay, can't get any smoother than that. And finally, let's use root to root, because we have that either fourth going up, E going to A, or the fifth coming down from E down to the A. Okay, so we've got the G, we've got the B flat, and we've got the E going. Okay, those are, I'm not saying that's the only way to do it, but those are three very good passing notes from E minor 7 to A7. What about going from the A7th to the D minor? Okay, so this is going to be a little more like what we're used to, because really it's not, the fact that we have the flat at 9th is not going to change anything in terms of beat 4. Okay, so very quickly, we want to go from A7 to D minor. Okay, so let's do the same thing we did a minute ago. How can we approach by using a whole step or a half step? Well, certainly we can go right the fifth down to the new root, so that's E going to D. Good. Then we can also go from a half step below the C sharp going up to the D. So it's the third going up to the root. And finally, we have that nice root motion again. So it's either the fifth coming down or the fourth going up. Now, in this key, we don't have a lot of choice in terms of, motion. We can't really go down to a low D. We just don't have one. So unless you want to use this D, you're pretty much stuck. So we have the E going down to D, C sharp going up to the D, and then we have the E either down or up. So let me demonstrate these passing tones with a slowed down version of the play along track.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
But I think you get the idea, and this is where having something to play along with really helps, because you can hear if what you're doing sounds good. Just a technical point, this track has 2-5-1 and then a 6 chord, which is a B minor 7 flat 5. Don't worry about it, because the D minor that you're playing works just fine with, okay, it's just a slightly more advanced version of the turnaround. Okay, so have some fun with this and see what you can come up with that sounds cool using this harmonic minor scale.